We got just one game left in the college football season, and it could be a record setter. I'm talking, of course, about the BCS championship game played later tonight in Miami. And it's got two of the most storied programs there is. Number one, undefeated Irish Notre Dame against number two, Alabama. Game, it's on cable. ESPN expected to draw about 30 million viewers, which, if it happens, it will make the game the most watched program in the history of cable television. Bama's favorite is about a touchdown and a half favorite going into tonight's game here. What I find interesting is you don't have a team remotely from New York. You don't have a team remotely from the West Coast. You have a team based in Indiana and in Tuscaloosa, Alabama, but yet you couldn't write a script more with the two most storied teams. I'm watching tonight, tickets are going for $2,500, $3,000 a pop. You know, it's crazy. But if I had told you before what would be the most viewed thing in the history of cable television, would you ever have guessed an Alabama Notre Dame game?
Yes.
We all said yes.
Thank you. Step on the lead. Yeah.
For the real football fans, this is going to be a great game because it's going to be a defensive game. It's not going to be spectacular.
Some of the biggest teams in college football ever. I mean, the history of these teams.
Notre Dame's like the Yankees. Notre Dame's like the Cowboys. They're a national team, and Alabama is like the team across the South.
You know, if the SEC wins again, I'm going to scream.
Yeah, I am getting tired of it, too.
You know, but I used to root against Notre Dame because they always used to win, you know, 20, 30 years ago. And so I'm kind of feeling sorry for them. I want them to win.
Can I just be the cynic who points out 30 million people watching, zillions in ad revenue, and the players on the field getting nothing?
Oh, yeah, getting for nothing another day. Tonight. For another day. They do have
good points.
Okay. Thank you.
Now, this other one. To me, it's going to be interesting how it plays out. You got, obviously, Lance Armstrong. Talk about a fall from grace. This weekend, there were rumors back and forth, will he or won't he, in years past. That would have been about winning the Tour de France, but instead, the seven-time winner will or won't come public that, in fact, he did abuse performance-enhancing drugs despite all the years of denials, et cetera. You know, I remember Pete Rose, people just said, if he comes clean, if he just comes clean, all will be forgiven, Charlie Hustle. He waited so long that when he finally put the book out, nobody bought the book because that was the only thing they wanted to know, and nobody forgave him because they said, you know what, he was a cheat after all, and he lied through his teeth. How forgiving, in the most forgiving nation in this war, in this country, in this world, do you think the American public will be for Lance Armstrong?
If Lance Armstrong loves his sport, he will, in fact, confess completely and just to clean up the sport and make it a sport that people will want to.
We already know his motivations are the most self-interested athlete I can think of.
But from his own point of view, no, people will not forgive him, but for the sake of his sport, he ought to do it.
I hate to do this to you, Mr. Chairman. It's not the crime, it's the cover-up. It's the fact that he had this massive organization in place to try to protect himself and inoculate himself,
and I think that's and really destroyed careers.
I think that's why he would not be forgiven, even if he came out.
I agree. I don't think they're going to forgive him, but I think for the sake of the sport that made him, that he should love, he should do it.
Every time I say the guy's never got a second act, Congressman, I'm surprised. I don't think with this. I think that the fact with the cancer and everything else, he offended people so bad.
Yeah.
I don't think people
look so much.
Yeah.
To me, he was the example of a quintessential athlete who did something beyond my comprehension. So first that he did it was bad, but continually denying it and denying it and denying it, that's what's worse.
And this is too. All right, we're going to wrap things up when we come back. Stay with us.